Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you are fine. Today we are discussing about exercise 6.4, fourth one. This is fourth problem from exercise 6.4. So our problem: a lending library has fixed charges for first 3 days. Here, lending library has fixed charges for first 3 days. And an additional charges for each day thereafter. John paid 27 rupees for a book kept for 7 days. If the fixed charges be X and subsequent charges per day is Y, then write the linear equation representing the above information and draw the graph of the same. From the graph, find fixed charges for first 3 if additional charges for each day thereafter is 4. Again, I repeat, find fixed charges for the first 3 if additional charges for each day thereafter is 4. Find additional charges for each day thereafter if the fixed charges for first 3 days is 7. These are the two questions we can find from the graph. This is the given information. A lending library has a fixed charges for first 3 days. Additional charges for each day thereafter. Thereafter means after 3 days. John paid 27 rupees for a book kept for 7 days. So here fixed charges is, we have to take X and subsequent charges are Y. The linear equation becomes, here fixed charges is X, subsequent charges per day be Y. So our linear equation, X plus 4Y is equals to 27. Here fixed charges per 3 days is X and subsequent charges for after 3 days is Y. So here John paid 27 rupees for a book kept for 7 days, means 3 days are fixed charges, remaining days are additional charges. So that is equals to X plus 4Y is equals to 27. So 4Y is equals to 27 minus X. Y is equals to 27 minus X by 4. Here our equation, Y is equals to 27 minus X by 4. Here I have to take, instead of X is equals to 3, minus 1 and 4. So why? Because when we have to substitute a value instead of X, it will be the, after the simplification, the result will be a multiplier of 4. So that's why we have to take X is equals to 3, minus 1 and 7. So here the calculation, when X is equals to 3, so Y is equals to 27 minus 3 by 4. 27 minus 3 is 24 by 4. So 4 how many times divides 24? 6 times. So Y is equals to 6. When X is equals to minus 1, Y is equals to 27 minus of minus 1. Substitute minus 1 instead of X in the given equation. So that is equals to 28 by 4. Result is how many times? 4, 7 times 28, Y is equals to 7. Next, finally, I have to take X is equals to 7. So substitute X value instead of X in the given equation. Y is equals to 27 minus 7 by 4. Result is 20 by 4. How many times divides? 5 times. Y is equals to 5. So write these values. Here Y is equals to 3, X is equals to Y is 6, When x is equals to minus 1, y is equals to 7. When x is equals to 7, y is 5. Plot these solutions on the graph so we can get the resultant graph of given data. First point, when x is equals to 3, y is equals to 6. When x is equals to 3, y is equals to 6. Next point, when x is equals to minus 1, what is the y value? 7. Here, draw parallel lines, which is parallel to y, and this line is parallel to x. Here is also, this line is parallel to y, this is parallel to x. Next one, last point, 7 comma 5. X is equals to 7, y is equals to 5. Draw a parallel line which is parallel to y axis. Draw a parallel line which is parallel to x axis. At y is equals to 5, here x is equals to 7. So, join these points so we can get the graph of given linear equation. X plus 4y is equals to 27. So this is the graph of John paid the charges to library. Our question is, from the graph find fixed charges for first 3. If additional charges for each day thereafter is 4. Here additional charges is y, so draw a line which is parallel to x axis. So after the extension, this dotted line meet this line at x is equals to 11. How? Because when y is equals to 27 minus x by 4. When y is equals to 4 means 4 into 4 is equals to 27 minus 6. So x is equals to 27 minus 16, that is equals to 11 is the answer. So this dotted line will meet this axis at x is equals to 11. Next question. Find the additional charges for each day thereafter, if the fixed charges for the first 3 days are 7. Here, first 3 days is fixed. So, charges for first 3 days is 7. When 7, what is the y value? So, y value is 5. Y value means subsequent charges per day. Here, our scale is on x-axis. 1 centimeter is equals to 1 unit. On y-axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 1 unit. This is the final result. So result is, when y is equals to 5, x is equals to 7. When y is equals to 4, x is equals to 11. The parking charges of a car in Hyderabad railway station for first 2 hours is 50 rupees and 10 for each subsequent hour. Write down an equation and draw the graph. This is our first question. Find the following charges from the graph. First one, for first 3 hours. Next one, for 6 hours. Third one, how many hours did Rekha park her car? If she paid 80 rupees per parking charges. Here parking charges for first 2 hours is 50 rupees. After 2 hours, each subsequent hour is 10 rupees. Then find these questions from the graph. So here number of hours we have to take x and charges is y. Charges for first 2 hours is 50 and charges for after 2 hours is x minus 2. Why? Because first 2 hours already completed, it is 50. So we have to take x is the number of hours, minus 2 is the first 2 hours. So x minus 2, that is equals to each hour after 2 hours is 10 rupees. The cost of each hour after 2 hours is 10 rupees. So our equation becomes y is equals to charges is equals to first 2 hours 50 plus after 2 hours x minus 2 into 10. So that is equals to 50 plus 10x minus 20. 50 minus 20 is 30. So finally our equation is y is equals to 10x plus 30. This is our required equation. Let's we have to draw a graph for this equation. This is the tabular form of our equation. So let's we have to take x is equals to 1, 2 and 3. Why? Because time is always a positive quantity. So that's why I have to take x is equals to 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour. So y is equals to 10 into, here substitute 1 instead of x. In our equation 10 into 1 plus 30, result is 40. We should write here, when x is equals to 1, y is equals to 40 rupees. These are charges y means. So when x is equals to 2 hours, so 10 into 2 plus 30, result is 50. So when 2 hour, charges is 50. When x is equals to 3 hours, y is equals to 10 into 3 plus 30. So result is 60. So we should write here. Draw the graph of these points. When x is equals to 1, y is equals to 40. When x is 2, y is equals to 50. X is 3, y is equals to 60. 140, 250 and 360. These are the points. When x is equals to 1, y is equals to 40. When x is equals to 1, this is x, x dash, y, y dash. X is equals to 1, y is equals to 40. Draw a line at x is equals to 1, which is perpendicular to x, parallel to y. So here is also y is equals to 40 means draw a line which is parallel to x at y is equals to 40. This is the point 1 comma 40. Next one, when x is equals to 2, y is equals to 50. When x is equals to 2, y is equals to 50. Next point, when x is equals to 3, y is equals to 60. When x is equals to 3, y is equals to 60. 360. So join these points so we can get the resultant graph of y is equals to 10x plus 30. This is the graph of given data. So this line represents the equation y is equals to 10x plus 30. So our first question is for 3 hours. So for 3 hours, what is the charges for 3 hours? It is 60. For 3 hours, rupees 60 is the charges. This is first one and second one. For 6 hours, what are the charges of 6 hours? So This is the answer for our second one. So when time is 6 hours, what are the charges? Draw a line which is parallel to y axis. It will meet the given line at y is equals to 90. So charges for 6 hours. So what are the charges? Y is equals to 90 means, y means charges. So x is the hours. For 6 hours, what are the charges? 90 rupees. Draw a dotted line from x is equal to 60, which is parallel to y axis. So this will meet our graph at this point. Draw a line from this point to y axis. This dotted line will meet the y at 90 rupees. So when x is equals to 6 hours, y is equals to 90 rupees. So for 6 hours, charges are 90 rupees. So finally, our scale. Scale on x axis. 1 centimeter is equals to 1 unit. On y axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 10 units. This is the final resultant of our given data. This is our 7th question. The ratio of molecular weight of hydrogen and oxygen in water is 1:8. Set up an equation between hydrogen and oxygen and draw its graph. This is our first question. From the graph, find quantity of hydrogen if oxygen is 12 grams and quantity of oxygen if hydrogen is 3/2 grams, means 1.5 grams. So this is the given data. The ratio of hydrogen and oxygen is 1:8. Draw the graph. This is our first question. From the graph, we have to find quantity of H. H means here hydrogen. If O, O means here oxygen is 12 grams. Find the quantity of hydrogen if oxygen is 12 grams. Next one, find the quantity of oxygen if hydrogen is 3/2 grams. Let's we have to take here hydrogen is X, quantity of hydrogen is X and oxygen is Y. So by the given data, X is to Y is equals to 1:8. 1:8, the ratio of hydrogen and oxygen, X is to Y is equals to. So X is to Y is nothing but X by Y is equals to 1:8 is nothing but 1/8. So here by the cross multiplication, 8x is equals to y. This is our required equation. So our equation is 8x is equals to y. Here it can be written as y is equals to 8x. So here I have to take x is equals to 1, 2, 3. These are grams. So y is equals to, when x is equals to 1, y is equals to, substitute x is equals to 1 instead of x in the given equation. So that is equals to 8x. So that is equals to 8 into 1 means 8. So when x is equals to 1 gram of hydrogen, what is the value of oxygen? It is 8 grams. Next one, when x is equals to 2 grams means hydrogen is 2 grams. So our equation, substitute the value in our equation, y is equals to 8 into 2. That is equals to 8 into 2 means 16. So we should write here. When x is equals to 3 grams, means hydrogen is 3 grams. So the value of oxygen is x is equals to 3. Substitute 3 value instead of x. So y is equals to 8 into 3. Resultant. So result is 24. We should write here. When x is equals to 1, y is equals to 8. X is equals to 2. Y is equals to 16. X is equals to 3. Y is equals to 24. Plot the graph by using these solutions. on x axis we have to take 1 2 3 up to 12 grams. Here on y axis 4 8 12 16 20 and 24 means the gap between unit to unit is 4 grams. So here first our point is 1 8, x is equals to 1, y is equals to 8. Draw a dotted line which is parallel to y axis. Here is also draw a dotted line which is parallel to x axis. Both coincidence point is 1 comma 8. Next point 2 comma 16. Here x is equals to 2. Draw a line which is parallel to y axis. Y is equals to 16. Draw a line which is parallel to x axis at y is equals to 16. Both coincidence points is 2 comma 16. Next, when x is equals to 3, y is equals to 24. Draw a dotted line which is parallel to y axis. Here is also y is equals to 24 means draw a line which is parallel to x axis. Both lines meet at here. This point is called 3 comma 24. Join these points, we can get the resultant graph. So y is equals to 8x. That is, this is the graph of given data, or this line represents y is equals to 8x. Here our question is, when oxygen is equals to 12 grams, what is the hydrogen? If oxygen is 12 grams, what is the hydrogen? Here, oxygen is 12 grams is here. Draw a line, dotted line, which is parallel to y-axis. Here is also, from this point to draw a dotted line, which is parallel to y-axis. This line will meet the x-axis at 1.5 units. So, means the result is 3/2. Next question. N quantity of oxygen if the hydrogen is 3/2 grams. Here, the x-axis represents the hydrogen. Y-axis represents the oxygen. So, next our question is, hydrogen is 3/2 grams. What is the quantity of oxygen? So here, hydrogen is 3/2 grams means 1.5 grams. Here, x-axis represents hydrogen. Y-axis represents oxygen. 3/2 grams means 1.5. The value is in between 1 and 2. So from this point, draw a dotted line. This line will meet this axis at this point. So, draw a dotted line from this point to y-axis. That dotted line will meet the y-axis at 12 grams. So, when oxygen is 12, what is the value of hydrogen? Hydrogen is 1.5 or 3/2. Next question. When hydrogen is 3/2, oxygen is 12 grams. This is the final result. So, the scale of the given graph is on x-axis. 1 centimeter is equals to 1 unit. On y-axis, 1 centimeter is also 4 units. This is the final resultant of given data. This is your homework. Here, x-axis represents time, y-axis represents distance. Time is a constant. In the 8th question, in a mixture of 28 liters, the ratio of milk and water is 5:2. Set up the equation between mixture and milk. It is not a equation between milk and water. It is mixture and milk. We have to set up an equation between mixture and milk. Draw its graph by observing the graph. Find quantity of milk in the mixture. Here our mixture ratio is out of the milk and water. Mixture ratio is 5 plus 2, that is equals to 7. So mixture and milk ratio, that is mixture and milk ratio is here. Mixture is 7, milk is 5. So 7:5. So here mixture we have to take x, milk is y. So equation becomes 7:5. By the cross multiplication we get the equation. So finally we can plot the graph by using substitution points. So here x axis represents mixture, y axis represents milk. In our 9th question, so here in a country like USA and Canada, temperature is measured in Fahrenheit, whereas in countries like India it is measured in Celsius. Here is a linear equation that converts Fahrenheit to Celsius scale. Here Fahrenheit is equals to 9/5 into C plus 32. Here F means Fahrenheit, C means centigrade scale. Centigrade scale used in our India. Fahrenheit scale used in our cold countries like USA and UK and Canada. So take C value as a 5 multiplier. Let's take integers also, means negative and positive numbers also. And also draw the graph of the above linear equation having Celsius on x-axis, Fahrenheit on y-axis. Here x-axis represents Celsius, y-axis represents Fahrenheit. So also find the below questions from the graph. If the temperature is 30 degrees, what is the temperature in Fahrenheit? We should find these questions from the graph. First question is, temperature is 30 degrees centigrade, what is the Fahrenheit? If the temperature is 95 degrees Fahrenheit, what is the temperature in Celsius? Is there a temperature that has numerically the same value in both Fahrenheit and Celsius? If yes, find it. At which value degree centigrade is equals to Fahrenheit? My dear children, today exercise 6.4 is completed. If you have any doubts in this chapter, please contact my number.